what's up?
I think glaciers carved all this out.
Good.
Science is a tool. It's just a process that we use to find out things about our world.
I'll find you one of those glacial lakes.
I think the best science is done because of this sense of awe and wonder.
When I'm outside learning about the natural world, I don't really need anything else.
Part of the left side is still evolving, so it's still an active land side.
The opportunities are endless here for research, for scientific exploration, and it makes me feel like, oh my gosh, I don't know anything, you know, because I want to learn so much more about everything in the park.
Denali has a really rich history of scientific research.
All too few of us are concerned about the rapidly progressing extinction of wildlife in the United States. The preservation of wildlife is an important part of park planning.
Denali was originally set aside for its wildlife populations. These biological processes exist in a landscape that's pretty much unchanged by humans.
From a scientific point of view, having this huge, intact ecosystem, it is an amazing opportunity to learn about the natural world.
People study things here so we have a baseline for what is and what was in the past, so that we know how much we're changing it as human beings.
It's basically a living laboratory. Denali is a place where you can watch life cycles.
Got a damselfly larva that time.
And really see animals acting the way they have for hundreds of years.
But it comes out like that, wham!
Alaskan insects all have kind of a unique story. Part of the reason we're at Denali is we know there's insects here, but we know they just haven't been looked at. The thing about insects is that if a grasshopper was the size of a cow, I think people would find them much more interesting.
It's that lake that's this happening.
It's such a little spider.
I see ya.
We're out here doing the small mammal monitoring project. We're gonna all go to R1.
Sure.
With monitoring, it's really exciting because you start to figure out the pieces of the puzzle on how the ecosystem is working.
We're capturing voles and shrews primarily.
So much of the biodiversity of mammal life on the planet is made up of actually small mammals like this.
This is a tundra vole. Its scientific name is Microtus echinomus.
I think it's fun to be able to say that I work in a place like Denali National Park. It's a big legacy. You can see all the different names of the people who have been researchers in the past.
Who knows what qualities, what discoveries it could be made that be for the great benefit of man? Because there are certain elements in the wilderness that, once exterminated, never can be replaced. Like taking a book from a library, and if the book isn't returned, then after a while the library is less and less, and there's less to be found and less to be learned.
We've studied just about anything you can think of here.
The fossil record here is really special.
It's the hadrosaur. This guy would have been a big herbivore.
In the same way that we can go out and explore the park today, we can actually explore Cretaceous Denali 70 million years ago.
They were truly Arctic dinosaurs, and that's really unique to the world.
That's definitely a dino track.
When you find fossils of different things that lived here in the past, it kind of just reminds you that you're part of this bigger picture that has existed over, you know, a really long time.
This is one place in the rocks where I can actually see how they're oriented.
I grew up and liked going outside and got really, really interested in just why the earth looks the way it does in a certain place.
That white stuff over there could be volcanic ash.
To me, that's really fascinating to be able to go to a place and look at a landscape and see why it looks the way it does and how it's changing.
So let's do a transect. Like,
there are a lot of big changes happening in Alaska that are consistent with a changing climate.
Maybe a temperature measurement.
And I get to learn about it as it happens and to tell people about it.
We're at the leading edge of thawing permafrost in Denali, and it has a lot of implications for the park resources.
You have these huge glaciers coming off of the roof of North America. is the rate of volume loss of the glaciers increasing. We go out and we backpack into one of the glaciers, collecting useful science, collecting the data about glacier change lets us know even the glaciers here are suffering. The overall trend is loss of ice across the whole Alaska range.
95% or more of all the glaciers in Alaska are receding, and it's receding.
These students are here as part of a Global Explorers Climate Change Academy. To be able to come here on the front lines of climate change deepens their understanding of the science infinitely.
Like 50 yards of a span.
It's really important for young people to get involved.
If we plant this native plant, then hopefully invasive plants won't come.
So that we can keep these wild places wild.
Being a part of a legacy project like this, to me, is a lot more meaningful than sitting in a classroom. It makes it a lot more applicable. It doesn't just seem like you're memorizing facts for no reason. It makes it less abstract and more personal.
I mean, I just think it's such a unique story, and I think we're still writing it.
There's new discoveries that happen here all the time, and we're still really exploring it.
It is very valuable to be able to use science to understand a place like this. That's how we view and understand the world, is through science, and that's how the best decisions are made.